Curiosity doesn't seem to be tied to any specific reward. It makes sense for organisms to seek food, water, sex, shelter, rest, wealth, or any of the other myriad nourishing and pleasant things in life. But what is good of deducing the nature of gravity or of going to the moon? A simple answer is that we never know if what we learn today might come in handy tomorrow. From an evolutionary perspective, there is good reason to keep looking, to be curious. Information helps us make better choices and adapt to a changing environment. Scientists who study the mechanics of curiosity are finding that it is at its core a kind of probability algorithm. Our brain's continuous calculation of which path or action is likely to gain us the most knowledge in the least amount of time. Curiosity is less about what you don't know than about what you already do. The old view is that curiosity and boredom are opposite ends of the same continuum. The new view, bored is not too curious as hungry is too full or thirsty is slick. Rather, boredom is a signal that you are not making good use of the part of the brain. In a 1994 paper, Lewis' team theorized that curiosity's direction is determined by the information gap, the sudden awareness of what you don't know and the immediate desire to fill that gap. But for the information gap to set its hook, it can't be too big or too small. Curiosity peaks when subject has a good guess about the answer but aren't quite sure. So the crux of the video is, never stop being curious. I've been counting days together.